فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه وبعد. All praise is indeed due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant every one of us acceptance, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect every single one of us, to grant us protection from the devil and from evil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us every form of goodness. Honored ulama, beloved brothers and sisters, and dearest listeners, as we had promised, we will be continuing with the last segment and section of this particular topic of marriage. It is a very, very important topic. In fact, the response I have got via email is immense and intense. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us protection. It shows how many difficulties and problems people are going through and how much misunderstanding shaitan has allowed to creep in, especially between husband and wife. Remember, try your best never to allow a difference of opinion to creep in when it comes to your marriage. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Try to be on best behavior at all times, because that is what will definitely enhance and promote a happy home, happy generations to follow, inshallah. Also, we need to realize that shaitan, the devil, Satan, one of the prime aims, one of the biggest plans he has is to differentiate or to cause a split between husband and wife. And this is why he goes to get his prize after he has split between husband and wife, and he is awarded a huge and handsome reward by his leader Iblis. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. That having been said, we also need to realize and understand that we spoke about appointing certain representatives from either side when there is a problem and the problem cannot be resolved by the two of them. We need to know that sometimes, yes, family members at times are not qualified enough, or their hearts are not clean enough to be able to help you. Sometimes family members themselves create the problem because they have something against the other party. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our doors of understanding. And this is why it is important that when we select a representative, the Quran says min ahliha, or from his family or from her family, either party. Together with that, let us select those who have intellect, who have experience, who have a genuine feeling, and not someone who is going to tell you break the marriage. If there is anyone who tells you just break the marriage, they are not genuine. You need to try and try again and try a third time and try as hard as you can before you even discuss the issue of splitting and separating. And each time you go to a new counselor, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to go to those who have sound knowledge of the Sharia together with experience. You need to know you are going to have to start all over again. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the heart to turn a new leaf and to forgive those who are our own spouses and to try as hard as we can. Then obviously we mentioned the fact of divorce being a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at times to get you out of a situation and to get you out of oppression and to get you out of that which might result in your mental downfall as well as emotional. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. It is also important that we realize that really nowadays we have a very, very great proportion or ratio of people who go through divorce. Very great. But the reason why they go through divorce is sometimes very basic, very small, a minor issue. Something very small, they allow it to grow and to blow out of proportion. This is why it is important to resolve a matter as soon as it starts. When a fire starts, you would be very intelligent if you actually extinguished it as soon as possible, rather than to wait for the whole house to catch and then you want to bring the dowser to come and now extinguish it. Even if you bring the whole fire brigade, they won't succeed. Your house will be burnt. When you see a small spark, immediately try and resolve it instead of waiting for the whole house to catch fire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. This evening I have chosen to go through three very important examples in the Quran, and really they are so deep and so beautiful, and they show to us the beauty of marriage, the beauty of our spouses, and the beauty of the life when we are together. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. The first example is that in Surah Al-Baqarah. I'm sure many of us know the verses off by heart, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes a husband and a wife. Allah says,
هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لِبَاسٌ لَهُمْ.
They are like clothing unto you, O men, and the men are like clothing unto you, the wives. So the wives are like clothing unto their husbands, and the husbands are like clothing unto their wives. It might seem a very light verse when you skip, when you like whip through it as you are reading the Quran. But believe me, today, if Allah grants us the acceptance, you will see the depth, or some of the depth, of this particular verse. What is clothing? Clothing beautifies you. That is the first quality of the spouse. They are meant to take the good out of you, inshallah, which means expose the good in you, inshallah. And they are meant to beautify you, and they are meant to give a good image of you, inshallah. You will not wear clothing that is that of disgrace. The same applies, your spouse is not meant to disgrace you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the first understanding. Thereafter, your clothing changes with the changing of the season. In the cold weather, you will wear warm. And in the hot weather, you will wear a little bit cool. This shows us the reason for this is to protect you from outside environment. Your spouse is supposed to protect you from outside environment. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was faced with Jibreel and revelation for the first time, he felt quite heavy, and he rushed down to his wife Khadija binti Khuwaylid radiallahu anha, saying, Zammiluni, Zammiluni, cover me, cover me. And his wife comforted him to the highest degree. That is also the term clothing, subhanallah. Providing comfort, providing warmth when warmth is needed, and providing the cool breeze when it is needed, alhamdulillah. So clothing also changes with the changing of time, and it fits into the situation. A person who is wearing hot clothing on a hot day will not like that clothing. They would sweat and perspire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding, and may He make us from those who can look into this example. Let's move further into the example. When it comes to clothing, if you have, for example, an operation where you have been medically operated on your belly or anywhere in your body, what would clothing do to you? It would cover the scars that you have. Allahu Akbar. Your spouse is meant to cover up for you, and not to go and tell the whole world, you know, my wife is like this and my husband is like that. No. You are meant to cover up. You are meant to be clothing. Over and above that, clothing is there in order to cover your private parts and your shame, as it were. So your husband or your wife, you as a spouse are meant to be protecting them, and you are meant to be looking after them, and you are meant to be covering up wherever you can. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us promote the good and look at the good and concentrate on the good. Whereas when there is something negative, yes, we do know inside that there is something negative, but at the same time it will not be exposed in public. Do not clean your linen in public. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Let's move further down that example. When you want to buy clothing, you first go to a shop that fits your pocket. You will not go to a shop where the cheapest clothing is 10,000 rands when your salary is only 500 rands. Which means when you are looking for a spouse, look for someone on your level. Look for someone on your level. Don't look for someone whom it is going to be so expensive to look after them. The marriage won't really work. May Allah protect us. Let me take the example further. When you walk into, say for example, this store, what size do you buy? Do you buy your size, or do you buy a bigger size or a smaller size? Even if you happen to weigh a little bit more, you will still buy clothing that is your size. Even if the clothing that is small and tight fitting looks very nice, maybe, if you were to buy that, it might look beautiful. Once you wear it, it will tear. Allahu Akbar. Look at that. So when you get someone who is not on your level of spirituality or on your social level, it might look nice, it might look beautiful. As soon as you get married, it tears. Allahu Akbar, may Allah protect us. The marriage won't last, it won't work, because the hadith teaches us about kafa'ah. Kafa'ah meaning to look for someone in your social standing, to look for someone whose likes and dislikes will be similar, to look someone on your spiritual level, to look for someone who will not be a burden upon you in any way, and who will not be so low or so high that you will not be able to reach below or to reach above in order to reach them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So tight clothing, no one buys. If you are a size 10 and you were to buy a size 6, you would have to keep it in your cupboard and closet. You won't be able to benefit from it. May Allah protect us. And if you were, for example, to buy clothing that is too big, say for example you are a 32 waist and you buy a trouser which is 38, believe me, it will embarrass you in public. Allahu Akbar. You might need a belt to hold it up. And when it comes to marriage, we don't want to talk about a belt. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Look at how beautiful the example of clothing is. The most intimate relation you have, whether you know it or not, is with your clothing. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection and understanding. That is the power of the Quran. We've only been through a segment of one verse. The power of the verse when Allah speaks about the spouse and Allah says, هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لِبَاسٌ لَهُمْ. They are like clothing unto you and you are like clothing unto them. Now do we see that in that verse, he is teaching us how to select a spouse, how to marry the spouse and how to live with the spouse as well. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Let's move on to another verse. If we open the verses of the Quran in Surah Fatir, we will find just before Surah Yasin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the fact that He has created us in pairs. Listen to what He says.
وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَكُم مِّن تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِن نُطْفَةٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلَكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا.
It is Allah who has created you from dust or from sand or from soil, and thereafter from the seed, and thereafter He has made you pairs. He has made you into pairs. Let's listen and concentrate. He is telling us that He has made us male and female. And then He is showing us immediately after that other creatures of His whom He has also made in pairs. And He is drawing to our attention that nothing goes wrong in the other creatures because they go according to Allah's plan. And if you were to go according to Allah's plan, nothing would go wrong in your union as well. Subhanallah. Have you ever seen anything going wrong between the sun and the moon, between the night and the day and so on? Never ever, because they listen to what Allah says to the T. The lesson is, if you were to listen to what Allah says to the T, nothing would go wrong as well. And this is an example given in Surah Fatir. Many of us think that we will receive and achieve happiness by undressing in public or by uncovering our hair. If that is the case, it is like the sun saying that today I really want to fight this moon. I'm going to come out at night. Allahu Akbar. The sun has never had a dispute with the moon because it obeys the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But with us, with our minds and brains, Allah is showing us that look, there is only one way to succeed. And that way is to adopt what Allah, the creator of yourself and every other creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has dictated. There is no other way to receive happiness. You know, when you have a Toyota, for example, wouldn't you be a fool if you arrived at the BMW showroom and you told him, I'd like to sell my car or I'd like to service my vehicle? You want to take a Toyota to those who did not make it? They will laugh at you. Now, that is a simple example. We don't see anyone with a Toyota taking it to the BMW showroom. Why do we see human beings who were made by Allah taking themselves to others besides Allah to look for goodness and happiness and to service them? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Simple example for the brain, for the one who wants to know. Imagine if your motor vehicle is not working and you were told that you need to put oil here. and you suddenly think that you are too clever. You want your car to work, the professional told you where to put oil and what is wrong with your vehicle. And you take the oil and you put it where the petrol is supposed to go because you think you are clever. What will happen? Your car will stop functioning. That is what we are doing with ourselves on a daily basis on a different level. Where we have problems, Allah gives us the solution in the Quran. He tells us what to do and where to do it and how to do it. And we go further and we don't want to do it the way Allah decides. That is why our spiritual vehicle will halt. It will come to a halt. It will grind to a halt. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to do that to us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us understanding. So after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says He created us in pairs, He gives us a few examples. And all of them are to draw our attention to how well they get on. And to draw the lessons therefrom. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says.
وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْبَحْرَانِ
He says the two oceans are not the same. They are two totally different oceans. This verse, he says it immediately after telling us that he has made us in pairs. He tells us, look, even the oceans, we have created them, they depend on one another. They are two. They come in pairs, Allahu Akbar. And this is why they are not the same, but they hold each other up. If one ocean did not exist, the other one would collapse. The two oceans are held together. One cannot call itself an ocean unless the other one is there. It will not be there. One might be green, one might be blue. One might be sweet, one might be salty. And subhanallah, not only the colors, one might be warm, the other might be cold. But they are holding each other up. Allah says,
وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَهُمَا بَرْزَخًا وَحِجَرًا مَحْجُورًا
We have kept between the oceans a barrier. They will not cross the barrier. Mother and father, husband and wife, you have a role to play. Do not cross the barrier. A wife is not a wife unless she has a husband. The husband is holding her up. A husband cannot go out on the street. A man without a wife cannot go and say, I'm a husband. They will take him to the mad hospital. You have to have a wife in order to call yourself a husband. So that is why the oceans are only called oceans when the two are holding each other up. Though Allah says they are not the same. A man is brought up in a totally different home and a woman is brought up in a totally different home. But the two of them together will help enhance one another. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us inshallah portray the best of qualities that we have and eradicate the negative qualities we may be having. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the differences in the two waters. He says,
هَذَا عَذْبٌ فُرَاتٌ سَائِغٌ شَرَابُهُ وَهَذَا مِلْحٌ أُجَاجٌ
On this side of the ocean you will find sweet water that you can drink. And on the other side you will find salty water, but you need that salty water as well and you need the sweet water as well. The salt pans, mashallah, you find them in Port Elizabeth and in other places, mashallah, where the water is more salty, alhamdulillah. So we need it for salt. Without salt in our food, what would happen? We would never ever be able to enjoy the taste of that food. Try your food without salt one day. And this is why it's important that no one must debate with one another to say, you are the sweet and I am the salt, or I am the salt and you are the sweet, and so on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. We are both equally needed. Both our qualities are needed within the marriage in order to make it work. So in the same way that you need the sweet water for the water, you need the salty water for the salt, alhamdulillah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says there is goodness on both sides of the oceans. Listen to what He says.
وَمِن كُلٍ تَأْكُلُونَ لَحْمًا طَرِيًّا
From both sides you will find fish. Fish is not on one side. So from this side you will find fish, the other side you will find fish. In the marriage you will find goodness with the bride, goodness with the groom. But would you ever get fish without going out to fish? Do the fish suddenly jump out of the ocean and say, right, eat me, mashallah. No, that's not what happens. Amazing. What would actually happen is you need to take a rod and you need to fish. But for your information, if you go to the ocean with a rod, you might only catch one fish. You rather go with a trawler and catch a lot, kilos and tons, alhamdulillah. And you can do business thereafter, alhamdulillah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us understanding. An effort is required if you want to achieve benefit from your spouse. An effort is required if you would like to fish. It won't just come to you. The same way, if you want to see the positive points in your spouse, you need to definitely work hard. You need to understand. You need to try. You need to think carefully. You need to make an effort, and inshallah you will find that benefit, the benefit of pure meat, inshallah, you will be able to benefit from it, inshallah. Let's move further. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَسْتَخْرِجُونَ حِلْيَةً تَلْبَسُونَهَا. If you want to make a bigger effort, you will be able to extract pearls from the deepest part of the oceans that you will then be able to adorn yourself with. So if you are ready to make a bigger effort in your marriage, you will be able to then see the shining of your spouse, the good qualities of your spouse, inshallah. But for that, a deeper effort is required. A great sacrifice is required. Ask those who die for pearls. They almost risk their lives. But when they come up with the pearl, mashallah. And they are so happy. It is worth a million other commodities of this dunya, subhanallah. So that is why if you are ready to put on that oxygen mask and go into the deep oceans, you will come out with the pearls, alhamdulillah. In your marriage, if you are ready to sacrifice, even though it might seem to you that it is almost broken, that's not true. I beg to differ. If there is an effort on both sides, inshallah, you will be able to extract those pearls and you will be able to come out with them. Don't worry about the adversity as you are diving. There might be sharks in the path. You might be scared, you might be bitten, you might this, you might that. But it is only with that effort that you will then be able to adorn yourself. And to be honest with you, husband and wife, they are adornment for one another, subhanallah. It is important that a wife dresses up to the T for her husband. If she does not do that, there is a chance and possibility that his eyes may wander. May Allah protect us all. And the same applies, it's no use to say the wife must dress up for the husband. The husband needs to be prim and proper as well, inshallah. Meaning, he must not come home smelling and filthy and then he expects, mashallah, to be intimate in the condition where nobody can tolerate the scent or the stench that is coming from him. May Allah protect us. To keep yourself clean is part of Islam and Iman. It is part of your faith. And we need to realize that the religion we are following has stressed on cleanliness more than anything else. We need to cleanse ourselves spiritually to start with and then even physically, inshallah. So if you are to make a bigger effort, inshallah, what will happen? You will then be able to dig deeper and go deeper and you will be able to receive, inshallah, the goodness and the benefit of your marriage. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, inshallah, in every single way. Let's move further, inshallah, through these verses. After speaking about the oceans, the fact that they are not the same, the fact that if you are to receive any benefit, you will get fish from both sides. There are different types of fish on either side. You will find a certain type of fish in one ocean and you might not find the same fish in the other ocean. So it does not mean that there is only one type of fish in the world. So many different types of goodness, inshallah. If one thing might go wrong, another 10 things will go right in your marriage, inshallah. And if there is one negativity, there will be so many other positives that you will not find elsewhere. That is a solid point that you need to think of. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us appreciate our spouses. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَرَى الْفُلْكَ فِيهِ مَوَاخِرَ لِتَبْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Allah says, when you see the ship, it cleaves through the waves. When a ship crosses from one ocean to the other, do you notice that you've crossed into another ocean? The answer is no. It crosses, it cleaves through the waves. For us, there are many lessons to draw from that, subhanallah. I will only come up with one or two. The reality is, you may be totally different, but when you are together, when the others, members of your family and so on, and the broader society happen to see you, you need to realize they must not notice the differences you have. Do not clean your linen in public. They will sail straight through like a ship sails straight through the different waters. It doesn't mean that now you crossed and suddenly the ship starts rocking and so on. Unless an expert will tell you we've crossed into the next ocean, subhanallah. Without that, you wouldn't have known. Is that not true? Yes, it is true. So the same applies. There might be certain people who might know that we might be going through turbulence. But as I said a few days ago, that you do not tell your sadness to others. Do not relate it to your friends or family for that matter to start with. You need to make sure you have tried your best to make that marriage of yours work, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to soften the hearts, inshallah. So as you have the ship moving across in order to benefit from the ocean, the same applies to us. If we'd like to benefit from one another, we need to abstain from cleansing our linen in public. When you have a problem, don't scream and shout such that the neighbors can hear you. And don't scream and shout in front of your own children. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. After that, the next verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us another example. The other example is that of the night and the day. He says, يُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ وَيُولِجُ النَّهَارَ فِي اللَّيْلِ وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرُ. The night goes into the day and the day goes into the night. That is the plan of Allah. Listen very carefully. What do we learn from that for our marriages? When the night goes into the day, if the day is short, the night automatically becomes long. And if the night is short, the day automatically covers up and it becomes long. Subhanallah. When there are shortfalls from your spouse, you need to make that extra effort to cover up, inshallah. If, for example, there might be one shortfall this side, you need to be extra good, inshallah, to cover it up. And if there is one extra point on this side, inshallah, then you may be relaxed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. The same way, that is the system of Allah. If Allah wanted, He could have kept day and night exactly equal all along. But He says, no, that's not what He does. When one changes, the other one exceeds or increases or decreases accordingly. What we need to learn from this is, you need to be tolerant. One day you might have to exercise more patience than the other. Something might happen in your house. Maybe someone might do something that you didn't really like. That day you need to have more patience. And another day when you do something that requires their patience, they also need to be patient and forgiving, inshallah. So there is a give and take in marriage. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. And look at how the night and the day never ever fail, because that is the plan of the Creator, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. They listen and obey to the instructions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we are to listen and obey, do you think something will go wrong? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all protection from shaitan and protection from the devil. So these are some of the examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us in Surah Fatir. Amazing. Let us now move to another surah. Surah Yusuf, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also speaks of a different example altogether. Remember, when the examples are given in the Quran, they are the examples of the Creator Himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There can be no mistake or no error when it comes to the plans or the examples, sorry, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No mistake. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of a dream in Yusuf alayhi salatu wa salam's surah, the surah where his story is mentioned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Yusuf alayhi salam told his father, إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ أَحَدَ عَشَرَ كَوْكَبًا وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ رَأَيْتُهُمْ لِي سَاجِدِينَ. Oh my father, I have seen the sun and the moon and 11 stars prostrate to me in a dream. And his father told him, oh my son, don't tell your dream to others lest they are jealous. So just leave it. Anyway, a long story short, right at the end of that surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the translation of the dream was made clear. What was the translation of the dream? The son that was in the dream was depicting the father, Yusuf alayhi salam's father, Yaqub, Jacob, may peace be upon him. So the son was depicting the father. The moon was depicting the mother. And the stars were depicting the children or the brothers of Yusuf alayhi salatu wa salam, the children of those parents. Now if we take a look at that example and we analyze it, it is a biblical example. It has no errors in it. It is flawless. The relation between the sun, the moon and the stars is exactly similar to that of the mother, father and children of any successful home. Subhanallah. Now let's go into that. The son, the qualities of the son are those qualities which are meant to be found in the father of any successful house. So the son is very strong, mashallah, very powerful in the home, alhamdulillah. The son shines. It gives a sense of security. When the sun is out, mashallah, that is when you find the plants will photosynthesize. There is growth, there is blossoming, there is blooming whilst the sun is out. When the sun is out, the stars are there, but you will not notice the stars because you cannot look at the sun directly with your naked eye. Doesn't that depict some form of respect between the parent, between the father in particular, and the children? Not to say that you cannot look him in the eye, but to say that he commands a greater respect in the house. That is the role. He is the breadwinner. Is that not supposed to be correct? In our homes, it is supposed to be the case. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us rectify that, inshallah. The father is supposed to play that role of being the breadwinner in the home. He is the one who is the final decision maker. What that means is, it is the father's duty to listen to the opinions of the mother and the children and others and so on. And on merit, he must then make a decision according to the best opinion that was presented to him. Or if his was even better, then he can make the decision according to his own opinion. Now, we have the son. Let's speak about it a little bit more. The role of the son is so great and so powerful. Just imagine for a moment as we go out on a gloomy day where there is a lot of cloud and there is no sun. What happens? On that day, you feel more like going into the bed and going to sleep. Allahu Akbar at times, depending on how dark and windy it is. Here in Cape Town, mashallah, in one day you can have four seasons, alhamdulillah. Sometimes it is as freezing as you can ever think of in the morning, and then suddenly it is so hot and moments later there is rain. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. I think across the globe the weather is becoming very erratic, and that is very, very closely indicative of the fact that we too as families are becoming erratic. One day we're happy and 2 minutes later we're fighting, and another 3 minutes later we actually really cannot do with each other, and 5 minutes later we don't want to see each other's face. That is the weather. That is what is going on across the globe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all protection. So the qualities of the son, if we look at them, there are many more, inshallah. We are meant to really be men who have those qualities. Let's look at the moon, mashallah. The moon, you can look at it. You can look at it and you can admire it. Beautiful moon, mashallah. And you can look at it all night and admire it, alhamdulillah. The mother of the home, the wife in the house. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the coolness of our eyes in our spouses and our children. Ameen. And then if you ask yourself, where does that moon get its light from? Does it have its own light? No, it doesn't. It gets the light from the sun. So the stronger the sun, the brighter the moon. Allahu Akbar. The more you play your role in a stronger manner, in a more fulfilling manner, the stronger the role of the mother will be in the house. If you yourself are not a solid father, what do you expect of your own wife being a mother? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So you have the role of the moon, beautiful. What happens to the stars? When the moon is out, you find the stars are twinkling, mashallah. They are twinkling up in the sky and you can see them, different sizes and shapes and colors, mashallah. This should be depicting the close relation between the mother and the children, mashallah. Because when the mother is around, alhamdulillah, the children are so close, and they are so close that they can actually say whatever they feel, with respect obviously, but at the same time they are there. Not to say that the children don't have a relation with their father, they are there. When the sun is out, the stars are still there. But the significance of the sun is so great that the little stars are not noticed. Allahu Akbar. So when the father comes in the house, he needs to be a role model for his children. That is what we learn. Subhanallah. If the father is not going to be a role model, then what will you have? You will start seeing stars during the daylight. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Let's take a look at the moon. Mashallah. The moon has a lot of peace in it, a lot of tranquility, calm, there is silence, people are sleeping, they are feeling relaxed at that time. These are the qualities that a mother in the home is supposed to be having when it comes to her own children. You take a crying baby, mostly that crying little baby, the minute the mother takes hold of the child, it will probably go to sleep. The comfort of the arms of the mother is equivalent to none other than the same mother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So that is the quality, or these are some of the qualities of the moon, subhanallah. Let us take a deeper look at the moon. Do you see a full moon every day? No, mashallah. We are not trying to say women are extremely emotional, but at the same time, what we are saying is, the moon is not there every single day. One day it's full, the next day it's quarter, the following day, possibly after some time it will be three quarter, then it is a crescent, we all look forward to finding the crescent inshallah, and some days it is not even there. Go out and it's not there, Allahu Akbar. The moon goes through a 28 day cycle, and so does every female by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to assist the women folk in this regard inshallah. So they will naturally have different emotions. We know of a medical term where they describe the emotions of a female just prior to those days. And we realize and understand it as well. The emotions are different. So in the same way, we need to realize and understand that we will not be able to see the moon every single day. We will also not be able to have the same emotions on a daily basis from the same female. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding and protection inshallah. The same applies if we are to try and look at the role of the moon. When we see the moon, we will then find that the sun will not be there noticeable, though it is right on the other side of the earth from where we are standing. The sun would be shining from the other side of the earth and it would be beaming its rays onto the moon. Hence, we on earth would then be able to see this moon. Let's move to one simple example. When you have an eclipse, what happens? What actually happens? The moon comes into the place of the sun and the sun comes into the place of the moon. And we find that we have an eclipse. They have confused their roles. What happens is, one comes into the path of the other, both of them disappear, and you won't see the stars. You definitely won't see the stars. And the hadith tells us that it is a sign of Qiyamah. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us, when you see the sun or the moon eclipsing, you'd better engage in dua until that particular sun or moon goes back into its course and you see it come back. You engage in dua, you engage in salah, because it is indeed a sign from amongst the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because one day the sun will rise from the west and set in the east. And that day it will be a major sign of Qiyamah. Some of the scholars make mention of an eclipse. And when the sun and the moon are eclipsed, then the sun will move in the other direction as it is coming out. And this is why we are told by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to engage in dua and to engage in the takbir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and salah until the sun returns or the moon returns to where it is supposed to be. That we know. There is a whole salah known as salah of the eclipse. Salatul kusuf or salatul khusuf. Now what happens is, we've heard a little bit of the roles of mother and father in the house. When mother wants to be father and father wants to be mother, what would happen? There would be a clash of roles. And this is why I have been saying for the last 2 days that it is not a battle as to who is more powerful. It is definitely a battle as to who is fulfilling their role in the best way. When mother wants to be father and father wants to be mother, there will be a social eclipse. There will be chaos in that home. And do you know who will suffer the most? The children will suffer the most. Because they are grappling and they are searching and hunting for guidance, for light, for love, for comfort. If they cannot get it from mother and father, they may then turn elsewhere, which might become extremely dangerous. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant our children inshallah the acceptance to see the benefit of both mother and father. Ameen. We also realize and understand that when a man wants to be a woman and a woman wants to be a man, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has cursed such people, and he says it is a sign of qiyamah, it is a sign of the end of times. We find nowadays, may Allah protect us all, we hope it is not in our homes, but in many places you find people have mixed their roles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has left the role of a female, the role of a female. And the role of a male is indeed a masculine role. We need to assume these responsibilities and we need to execute them in the best way possible so that we can achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why it is important that we look at these examples in the Quran and we extract the jewels and the diamonds from these examples. They are not coincidences. They are carefully planned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And really, if you open the books of tafsir, there will come a time when you will come through so many different examples of the Quran, just the parables, just the similitudes of the Quran, where you can derive a lot of benefit therefrom. Take a look at this dream, Allahu Akbar. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us benefit from this dream, inshallah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open the doors of all of us in this dunya and in the akhirah. Remember to fulfill your role. Remember the qualities that are required of a male. Remember the qualities that are required of a husband in the house. And the qualities of a wife in the house. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us really from those who can uplift and uphold. And at the same time, when it comes to the children, we need to have a very good link and relation with our children. The doors of communication need to be open 24 hours of the day. If your child cannot communicate with you and cannot tell you exactly what is in his or her heart, then probably your relation with them is not ideal. Because then they will go to the neighbor, they will go to their friends at school, they will go elsewhere, and they will want to get help from people who are not qualified enough, nor do they have a genuine feeling, nor do they sometimes have parents who have looked after them. Rather, they will be educated by the television. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. So it is important to have a very open relation. And an open relationship does not mean you must let them get away with murder. No, where they are wrong, you need to speak to them, convince them, talk to them, tolerate what they are saying, but then utilize your mind to convince them. The reason we say convince them is, if you were to use the stick in order to make sure that whatever you say goes, then for as long as you are present, they will listen to you. The minute you go out, they will be on the other side. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. But if you have convinced your child to do something, then naturally, that even in your absence, the child will know, I've got to read my salah. Why? Because of this benefit, that benefit, that benefit. I've got to tell the truth. Not because my father is going to beat me up. No, because I have a responsibility to my creator. I need to be a good, loyal, lawful Muslim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So the idea or the issue of communication, both within the marriage between husband and wife, as well as the children, is extremely important. And we'd also like to open one more door of communication, or the importance of one more point of communication is between the parents and the children, the in-laws and the sons or daughters-in-law. That is also a very, very important door. And remember one thing, whenever you want to correct someone, don't hold back. Whenever you want to correct someone, even if they are going to feel bad, for as long as you are polite and respectful, subhanallah, if they are decent human beings, they will understand it. If not today, then tomorrow. You are not allowed to leave back correction where you feel that someone is going wrong. You need to address it as soon as possible, because if you don't, they will plunge deeper into the disaster, and it may have a ripple effect or a skittling effect whereby so many other people will be harmed by the damage of you not having corrected the individual or the person. So even if your parents are going wrong, your children are going wrong, your spouse is going wrong, your in-laws are going wrong and so on, you need to, with utmost respect, open the doors of communication and speak to them, inshallah. And through this communication, we will achieve and receive goodness, inshallah, if we are sincere and we are good. There is one more point before I end for this evening, and that is, many times, as human nature, As human nature, people think that they are the only ones who are right. And what happens is you sit and you listen to an opinion and you say, no ways, this is out. Believe me, the criteria is whether or not Allah has commanded it. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger have instructed something, yes, then we will shut off and we will listen to that inshallah. But when it comes to other opinions of this world, your spouse, your children, your parents, your in-laws, believe me, it cannot be overstressed for us to say that we definitely need to listen to others' opinions and give up your view. Giving up your view at times when it really is just a worldly opinion is sometimes a very great act of worship, and it will help resolve and solve so many problems in your marriages and in your homes. Just by giving up your opinion, you definitely dearly think and believe that things must happen this way. Believe me, for once, please try and turn and see another direction. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us in every single way. I've decided to keep it a little bit shorter today, as it is the second last night. Tomorrow, inshallah, we will be completing the Quran in this masjid. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us all and to grant us all the acceptance to have listened to every single word of the Quran. And at the same time, tomorrow evening, we hope and pray that we can go through some of the supplications and du'as that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made mention of in the Quran, with the idea of benefiting from it, starting with the fact that we need to make a dua that Allah grant us spouses and children who will be the coolness of our eyes. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Furqan, describing the believers, the true believers. He says,
وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا.
The true believers are those who make a prayer to say, O Allah, grant us from our wives and our children those who will be the coolness of our eyes and make us leaders of the righteous. Subhanallah. So this dua, we need to make it on a constant basis. The reason is, if you are not married, Allah will grant you a spouse who will be the coolness of your eyes together with righteousness. And if you are married, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can help improve your condition as well as the condition of your spouse through the same dua and supplication. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us happiness in this dunya as well as in the akhirah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us help one another. And at the same time, may He really help us to enter Jannah through His mercy. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah bihamdih. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.